Hello out there, and welcome to my channel. Today I'm not going to talk about this wise lathe or this wise mini lathe, but on this old lathe that I use to cut my gear wheels. Today I will try to explain how I cut my worm gear wheels or helical gear wheels. I bought the lathe about 40 years ago, as I recall, and I was told that it was used for smaller repairs at a telephone company. I'm not sure about the age of it, but I think it was made about 1920, or perhaps earlier. This was, in fact, my very first, let's call it, mini lathe, and it was in a remarkable good condition when I got it, with only a little wear on the bedways, the headstock, bearings and so on. And I used it several years to cut small items like side feet oilers, handles and so on, until I got my Myford ML7 lathe. Before I moved this lathe from my outer workshop to this cottage, it was mounted to a very heavy cast iron cabinet stand. The cabinet stand had in the middle a shaft going through. One end of the shaft had pulleys belts to be connected to pulleys on the headstock spindle. And the other end of the shaft had a very heavy flywheel. And I think before the lathe got electrified, it was manual operated by a foot pedal connected to a crankshaft to this heavy flywheel. I can still operate the lathe by means of a 12 volts DC motor. I had to take off the back gear to make space for the belt. When I made one of my first hot bulb engines, I decided to try to make worm gears to connect the crankshaft to the side shaft and the side shaft to the flywheel governor. And that's the setup I ended up with, like cutting multi-threads. But to make multi-threads, you need a dividing head. I use a gear wheel mounted to the headstock as a dividing head. In this case, it's a 60 teeth gear wheel. As you can see, the gear wheel is marked with 12 marks all the way around, which means that I'm able to cut worm gear with 6 teeth or 12 teeth. When one teeth is finished cut, I move the gear wheel, take it off, and turn it around to the next mark that's corresponding with this gear wheel. But I will show you this in practice in a minute. To make worm gear teeth with the right cutting angle, the lead screw, this one, and the headstock spindle must be connected via gear wheels in the right ratio. This setup is for a 12 teeth gear wheel with a cutting angle of 17 degrees. When I cut my gear wheels, I do not turn the headstock spindle, but the lead screw with this hand wheel or this DC motor. At first I used this handwheel for manual turning, but later I mounted this DC motor. It can be engaged or disengaged. The DC motor is an old wiper motor from a Volvo, as I recall, and I have made a forward and reverse switch for it. To the left and to the right. At first I used this handwheel for manual turning, but later I mounted this DC motor. It can be engaged or disengaged. The DC motor is an old wiper motor from a Volvo, as I recall, and I have made a forward and reverse switch for it. To the left and to the right. To make it more easy for me to control the travel of the carriage, I had mounted two adjustable switches to stop the carriage at certain points, one for the left travel and one for the right travel. And it works like this. You might wonder what this hand wheel pulley, the belt, and the two springs are for. It's a light brake, so to speak, for the lead screw to have a more precise stop of the carriage. Although you have switches to break the power for the motor, there will always be a bit after run of the carriage, so to speak. And it's to prevent the cutting tool from hitting the shoulder of the workpiece or the chuck. And it's only a light break. The workpiece, I have made a setup to cut 3 12 teeth gear wheels. I have cut 3 teeth and about to cut number 4. And the last cut So now it is time to turn the headstock gear wheel one spot to cut a new tooth. The gear wheel has a lock pin to fit a hole in the headstock spindle. Off with the gear wheel, turn it to the next spot, it's there, and then turn the headstock to fit the lock pin and lock the lock nut. Now I only need the last cut and the gear wheels are finished. I take the last cut two times. That's it. Let's take off the gear wheels and see how they fit. So let's have a look at this finished 12 teeth worm gear. See, okay. It's meant to mesh with this 6 teeth worm gear. This is for the crankshaft and this is for the side shaft. Well, it seemed to be okay. And then you might ask, how long time does it take to make these three 12 teeth worm gears? Well, it takes about half an hour to cut the teeth, and then of course there's a gear train connecting the lead screw to the headstock, and then of course machining the brass rod to the right side. So let's say a good hour, perhaps 1.5 hours. Now, this is my worm gear cutting tool. It consists of a shaft inside a square, let's call it a block, and one side of the block is cut to be able to clamp around the shaft to hold it tight. At the end of the shaft we have the cutting tool of itself. It's a piece of tool bit grinded to fit between the worm gear teeth, and it's clamped to the shaft by means of two set screws. When cutting worm gear teeth, the cutting tool angle or pitch must be the right. Therefore, the shaft must be able to rotate in the block. I have drilled three holes through the block and the shaft to be able to adjust the cutting tool for the right pitch or angle. At this moment, the cutting tool is locked at 17 degrees. It was when we cut the four worm gear wheels, and it can be adjusted to 73 degrees or 45 degrees. Let's change the cutting angle. Off with the pin and rotate the shaft to, let's be at 73 degrees, and then in with the pin again. Some different gear wheels made on the old lathe. Starting at the left, a gear wheel with a pitch of 17 degrees, 12 teeth gear wheel, the one we just made. Next, gear wheels with 45 degrees, it's an 8 teeth gear wheel, 10 teeth, a 20 teeth, a 25 teeth, and a 30 teeth, and then gear wheels with a pitch of 73 degrees, a 6 teeth gear wheel, a 12 teeth gear wheel, and then at the right we have two gear wheels, a set with straight teeth. The small has 22 teeth and the big has 44 teeth. The first gear wheels I made on the old lathe was this set of gear wheels for a horizontal gas engine. This was, in fact, the very first worm gear set I made for this horizontal hot bulb engine to connect the side shaft to the crankshaft. That's all for now. Thank you for watching, and bye bye.